It's almost time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Blast off.
So today I'm here with someone who I knew very little about, and I'm hoping this session is going to be a discovery not just for me but for everyone listening at home. Yuval Gantz.
Hey.
Nice meeting you. You have been super friendly.
Thank you.
I've loved meeting you. I love vibing in your amazing studio.
Thank you.
This place is cool. Best way to like grasp who you are and the music that you make is maybe talk about how you grew up and who you were and where you come from. So I always like to go really back to the beginning. So going back as early as we can.
So I grew in a little town called Ramat HaSharon. It's this small suburb near Tel Aviv. Yeah, I guess kind of a quiet town. Not too much to do around. So definitely a lot of hanging with the friends. Musically also created this vibe of just meeting every day and creating, and yeah, that kind of fill in the void of like a city that, you know, gets dark at 8 and it's a ghost town, you know. But yeah, definitely the music and the people that I met there were truly amazing.
Nice. So would you say your childhood growing up in that town, was it very much you were into music even then?
Music for me was, it wasn't never like, I never committed to it until a certain age. Like I think since 16, 17, I realized it's more of a, more than just a passion. You know, like when I was younger, I went play basketball, play soccer, I went swimming, whatever, you know, and tried everything. But I think music just stayed there for above all. And with time, I realized it's not just about like playing, but it's really feeding me more than just practicing, you know. It's food for the soul.
So do you come from a big family? Do you have many brothers and sisters?
I have two brothers. I'm the smallest. I have an older brother, and in between is the sister.
Cool.
Yeah.
And are they all musical?
No, actually I came not, like my family is not so much, wasn't so much music around growing up. I think, you know, listening to the radio and things like that, but not like a big music lover. It's not that I had like records to mess with when I was younger. Yeah. Or so. Time I found my people that actually opened my eyes to this kind of music. And then like in 16, 17, I started like, oh wow, there's like so much out there, you know, and started exploring all these genres that I usually didn't have the
access
patience
to, yeah.
Even to listen to, you know. Okay. Like jazz or yeah.
What kind of music was coming out on the radio during that period?
I think this traditional folk song, these were like songs that everybody can hum, you know, but it's not that it made me this special feeling inside, you know.
Yeah. And then you said when you got to 16, 17, you started digging your own stuff.
Yeah, I think that time I started focusing more like about music and also hanging out with musicians. And then they start to play this music and like in hangs or whatever, like funk, hip hop or jazz, whatever. And everything was new to me because I didn't search for this kind of things. And then I fell in love in this game of, oh wait, what was so cool, okay, let's download the album, get mindful about it. And it was a super fun time.
Where would you go to vibe musically then?
So one of my friends had a home studio and we just all went and played there every day. And also, yeah, in Tel Aviv, you know, there's all these jams or whatever, and it's like a 20 minute ride from my house, so meet in Tel Aviv.
Yeah. So then what would you say as a song, if we come to our first selection, what would you say is a song that best represents your childhood?
My childhood? Well, I'm gonna take the peak of my like 17, 18. I think that time was kind of reinventing myself and learning a lot of new things and really focusing about being happy. I think that one of my happiest times being alive. I remember just being surrounded by amazing people that just made me laugh and enjoy life, which is something I cherish until today. Yeah, so I would go for definitely Celebration by Kool & The Gang. to describe that time. It was just about hyping, to be honest. Yeah. Hey, I'm Yuval Gantz, and you're listening to Groove School.
So we heard the music that you grew up listening to. When did you start finding your own type of music? So you said your friends were showing you some stuff and you were listening to some stuff, but when did you start, right, I've got a sound now, I'm gonna start getting my own?
I think until today I can't say I have a sound for it's like reinventing itself every day, but definitely I think the first thing that captured me in music was like beats, drums. It was funny because I'm a guitar player and I got really in love with drums, so hip hop and like beat makers was like my bread and butter for big time, you know, listening to The Roots and Questlove and J Dilla and all these people that created this, I don't know, an entire world of music that keeps growing with every generation and still keeping that authenticity in the beat making, and it's, yeah, I'm still until this day in love with this.
You can't, Jay Dilla, you can just,
yeah,
come
yeah.
on, he's mad. So then you like these kind of music, so you love beats. How did you collect the music? Did you buy vinyls? Or
I think, like as I said, I didn't grow up in a hoarding vinyl family, yeah. So it wasn't so much a thing for me, but yeah, definitely downloading a lot of music. Yeah, every album that I, or a tune that I like, I just like straight away went searching for it.
Have you got a massive library of music, would you say?
So I was really lucky because my friend transferred me his like entire library of music, which was like, I don't know, 500 giga or something like this of really good stuff. And that kept me running for a while, but then I got my computer kind of broke down and everything got lost, and then I still see it in my iTunes and I'm like, so close. but through him a lot of music.
When you were listening to these beats and JD, like you said, and I'm sure there's other kind of music that you're getting into, did you find it difficult to find people to vibe with, or was it something that you did very much on your own?
It was the easiest thing to find, to be honest. I was surrounded by people that were just really passionate about doing music and loving music. It was just every day we ring each other, let's meet, let's make songs, let's it's work and it's fun.
So you love it that much, then the next thing I can offer has to be something that will really help this love you have for music. So I'm going to do something that I like to offer everybody, which is I'm going to throw you a party. And this party is the party of all parties. I mean, no costs, you don't have to pay anything. I'm going to take care of all the costs and even have the power of bringing back some past artists and bring the present artists together. Mm-hmm. But mm-hmm. you only can pick three.
Oh.
So you can pick three artists, and for each artist that you pick, I want you to pick a track. They'll play many, I'm sure.
Okay.
But pick one that you want to listen to at home to say, right, this is why you like this guy.
Mm-hmm.
So who would the first one be?
Okay, oof, that's kind of not an easy one. I think first one I will go with Roy Hargrove, a trumpet player, recently deceased. Listening to his music while I was younger, like that's first time for me listening to brass and being like, what's going on? And it's like contemporary and funky and jazzy, and I don't know, it really captured me, and his music really shaped me as well. So definitely if I had an opportunity, I would bring him to play some tunes.
And what song would you pick?
I would go for Stenbrook Saint-Denis. That's actually not from his project that played the more contemporary stuff. It was his jazz quintet, but this song has so much soul that it's kind of hard not to move while you listen to it, so...
We'll be right back. second now. Who are you picking?
Well, I said his name already, but it's kind of an easy pick for every beat maker. I mean, J Dilla to come and spin some stuff at your party. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be a good party.
Yeah, J Dilla's there. It's done. You sell many tickets, but it's free anyway because I'm taking care of all the costs. But that'd be mad.
Yeah.
And what song would you pick?
I would go for So Far to Go. Featuring D'Angelo and Common. Easy pick.
Choice.
Well, I've seen him live a couple of time, but every time was really an outer body experience, and he also really shaped me as a musician. Robert Glasper, the pianist, and his experiment also just released a new album that I'm like already hooked. So yeah, he's truly inspiring.
And what song would you pick for him?
I would go for Yeah.
Hey, this is Alicia Joy from 3070, and you are listening to Reuben Green on Croydon FM.
I think beauty's overrated. That's something anyone can be. Yeah. Attraction, now that's something different. And thankfully you're bold to me.
Cause I've learned in this life,
yeah,
you gotta be with someone you like.
What
you think we've got,
yeah,
to go to distance, I can tell you now. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah.
You're sweet, and you see through me. You let me be free. I'm woman.
Oh,
selections were amazing. I'm sure everyone listening at home loved them. Where would it be? Where would you have this party? Where would you place it? If you could pick anywhere.
Oof.
Venues that you've been to, countries that you've been to. It could even be a house party if you wanted, you know.
I mean, okay, well, I'm caught off guard.
It's a question I didn't prep you for.
Yeah, you didn't prep me for this one. I'd say somewhere in the desert, to be honest.
Why is that?
Even in the Israeli desert. Yeah, every experience I had there.
Do people have parties and stuff in the desert?
Yeah, a lot. A lot of festivals are being held there.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
I don't know if the camera can see, but there's another gentleman here, Ron.
Yeah.
Yeah? You guys are saying the desert is the place to be, yeah?
Yeah, yeah, definitely. It's like going there and you look, it looks like Mars, you know? It's like...
Oh my goodness. I've never experienced anything like that.
Yeah, deserts are...
You said I should come at some point, so that is what I'm going to be hoping to see.
The invite is open, man. Wow. I'm waiting.
So at this point, we heard the music like love listening to, the music you grew up listening to. We just heard your super cool party. we know the music that you like. At what point did these types of music and these sounds start to make you feel like you want to make music yourself?
I think what has in common for all of these like tunes or all these genres is there's a lot of freedom in the music. Like you listen to it, either it's a... just an open groove that like I can listen for hours for the or the craziest solo with the most intense colors, and you listen to that and you just get inspired, you know. And I don't know, the straight away send me to a place of okay, I want to try and do something like that, you know. So you just start messing around with your instrument and that was cool, okay, and you play with your guys, something pops up, and that's like first songwriting, you know, that's how it starts. But everybody were like really into it at the time, also now. So
so when did you start playing guitar?
13.
And was that the first instrument you started to learn to play?
Yeah, I think I play bass also today, but definitely guitar is my main instrument.
Did you have a hero in guitar that you're like, I love this guy, I want to play like this guy? Or?
It always changed, you know, like sometimes, because there's so many and there's so many genres that you listen to, and there's so much to take from every player, you know. Also, after a while, you realize that notes are notes, you know. It doesn't matter like what instruments you play. I'm getting more inspired sometimes by listening to pianists, you know, like if I said Robert Glasper, for example, you know, like listening to him and how he plays and how he accompany a singer, like, I don't know, really get me inspired. And then
the way the sounds might influence on certain parts.
Exactly,
of the song,
when like, to be quiet, yeah. how to, like, okay, so people show you a chart with some chords and say, okay, this is a chord, like, there's so many ways how to play that chord and what to do with it and how to treat the music at that moment. So
did you study music at all?
My study was like private teachers along the way, and I also went to this school in Israel, Limon, and did this program there when I choose which course I want and then just focus on that.
Cool.
But mostly like I think what I picked, the main things was like from private people that I felt like I can gain a lot from them.
Yeah.
I also believe that if you have a teacher, you should have like a, it's a very intimate relationship.
Yeah,
you
yeah,
know?
Yeah.
It's like a sort of a master, you know? So yeah, I had like three that accompany me all the way.
Nice. And when you started playing and making music then, what genre did you hope that you wanted to make? You're like, right, I want to make music like this. It was like the first one. I know that you like many.
I think The Roots was like one of the bands that I was like completely mined from. Like I also saw them now like about a month ago in Berlin for the first time, and it was a closure for me.
Wow.
Yeah, it was an exciting moment. I went to the show by myself, just gazed at the stage for like 2 hours and went home and wept in my bed.
I've never done that, and I've never gone to a gig on my own.
Well, I've been doing it here so much.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. In a place like Berlin, you see all the artists you really want to see. They just go by here, like touring or just swinging by. And then you see this event and like, what? I can, I can miss that, you know. Let's just go. And if somebody, nobody want to go, I'll just go by myself.
And you probably meet like-minded people because you like the same.
Yeah, or mostly just like watch the show and be completely in the moment there, like
in awe,
mesmerized, you know.
So we're talking about music that you first like went into makes. You're talking about the roots. Mm-hmm. What is the first song you ever made? Do you like still remember it? Do you still have it?
No, no, I don't know. Like, no.
That's funny. So after you like learned how to play the guitar and you knew that you wanted to start to make music, but you, your first track was hidden from the world. No one knows. When, what did you decide to do? Do you want to work with a band or by yourself? What did you do?
Yeah. So for the last 4 years or so, I've been working with 3 other guys on a project called the Alaska Snack Time. And that's been like my passion project for the last 4 years. We've been rehearsing like every week and touring and performing, and now we released our second album. We worked about it, worked on it for 2 years.
Wow. So what's the name of the first album?
Alaska Snack Time.
Okay. And then the second one?
Know Your Enemy.
And how was this second album?
It was very interesting. First of all, we worked with a producer named Jonathan Albalak, who is an amazing musician, and I feel like we couldn't have had a better fit to this album with him, a person who can understand dealing with abstract and beats and four not easy people. To everybody's so opinion. It's kind of hard work, but it was really amazing. It took too long because we took every moment to find the right note and the right sound. And I don't think I've ever worked on something that long.
Okay. How long was it?
2 years.
Wow.
Just like, we had the song since the beginning. We came to him with the songs and we just chose what to work on. But like until we got it to be what we wanted to be, to kind of like 2 years. But I'm super proud about this project and this album. Very special music with special people.
Nice. So we didn't prep this bit, but for sure I'd like you to pick a track for the next selection. What track would you like to pick?
So there's one tune named Strasse, actually about the streets of Berlin.
Cool.
So I'll go for that.
Hey, du hörst gerade Groove School und das ist die Melodie Sinfonie für deine Liebe. Oh,
You were playing in this band. What made you want to work by yourself?
It's not that I wanted to work by myself. I'm actually way more driven to be surrounded by people and have a more of a family workflow. But I think I was wanted to ask some questions, you know, wanted to change some things in life, see new things, try other things. Also, I think Europe is a really nice place to be because you're not limited by traveling your surroundings and connecting with people. So, and Berlin has been one of my favorite cities since I'm 17, so definitely it was an easy pick.
So what is it like being here in Berlin?
It's very interesting. I mean, Berlin has kind of two waves you can ride on. The open, accepting, beautiful people kind of vibe that is very thrilling. But the city has like some dark sides. In winter, you can definitely feel it.
Coming from like Tel Aviv as well.
Yeah, I'm coming from a hot country, man. Yeah. It's winter jacket for me is already too much, and here it gets cold. So yeah, but a lot of beautiful people and artists just spread around all over, and it's a huge place with so chaotic but organized at the same time. The city has like this very unique charm that I don't know, for me it just makes sense. I guess for some other people it might not, but
no, I can relate. We've been here 4 days. It's very different, chaotic but organized as well.
I
completely agree with that. And then maybe musically then, why do you think it's brought together so many artists? There's so many here.
I think, like I said, Berlin has this very open wave. Like you can see so many collaboration of art with dance and music, and there's like really amazing art and culture in this place, and it's located in a very nice place in Europe. You're close to the UK, and it's a good place to be.
It's so weird to say, not say. So we saw K.Zia, we saw Sedric, and you guys have got a song out now.
Yeah, we released a song not too long ago called Blessing, which actually kind of talks about being grateful and meeting people here and having a unique connection. But I feel everybody have this lonely feeling till the amount, the difference between people here. And then when you meet somebody with like a beam of light, it's a blessing. And then, definitely both of them are really amazing people. I'm truly happy I met here. And the song was just created on a random night when we just went to K.Zia's and hung out and started vibing out, popped out.
Nice. We're lucky enough that we're going to hear a live version. But like you said, it's still available, so you can listen to it.
Yeah. Any platform. Hi, this is Yuval Gantz. I'm here with Reuben, and you're listening to Groove School.
I can't control you, but I wanna know you before we move on. Feel this connection, is it a blessing? For someone else, I can't control you, but I wanna know you before we move on. Feel this connection, is it a blessing? For someone else but me, whatever happens, I feel I want to give it a try. 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 Try. Give it a try. And try. Give it a try. Try. Give it a try. I can't control control you, but I wanna know you before we move on. Feel this connection, or is it a blessing for someone else? I can't control you, but I wanna know you before we move on. Feel this connection, is it a blessing for someone else but me?
Someone else but me.
Current artists are you listening to?
I've been digging Sampa the Great recently. I've been seeing her name all around. She's coming to Berlin now as well, aka artists that are always gonna come here. Yeah. It's so nice.
She's mad.
Yeah, like really amazing beats and unique productions. And
yeah, my friend put me onto her and her album Return. It's so varied. Like the styles of the songs are so very, she's so good.
Yeah. Really unique.
Yeah.
I listened to her older one though. Honey Bee,
like EE9.
Yeah, I think something like that, yeah.
Also really good.
Yeah.
She's just good. What can we expect from you? So I know that you've got your new track coming out, you've got a track out already. What more can we expect coming up this year and next year?
I think I'm just gonna keep trying to get artists here and collab, create music together, and I don't know, I'm coming from a very family kind of vibe, you know, with my friends and the people I create with, and it's something that for me is very important in my creation. So definitely looking to bring in people close and create this house for artists to create, and feel like they can always come here and
I like that.
Feel
nice.
The beans, you know.
I feel really welcome here.
You've been
really welcome. You've been so nice. This interview's been great. Hope to hear from you very, very soon. I want to come back. I want to come to Tel Aviv.
I'm going to come to London.
We're going to hang. We're going to have some good times, man. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much. Hey, I'm Yuval Gantz, and you're listening to Groove School. Cool.